This approach works for the coin tossing problem. But there are lots of other situations where we need to commit to values, and we need to commit to values much longer than just one bit. And for that, we need something a little more versatile, but with the same idea. What we need for this is what's called a cryptographic hash function. It's a function that has this property that it takes some large value as an input and outputs a small value. So this is similar to a regular hash function like we used in the hash table. It has the property that maps values from a large input domain, and by large here, we usually mean infinite, such as all possible strings of any length, to a small fixed output size. It should also have the property that it's well distributed, that for any given input, the probability that that input maps to a particular value is close to 1 over the size of the table. And we'll use n to represent the output size. So we'll say the outputs are in the range from 0 up to n minus 1. And so if it has this well-distributed property, well, this works great for a hash table. This is not enough for cryptographic commitments. If we just had these two properties, well, it might be easy to find other x values that map to the same thing. And we saw that one of the things that we need for a cryptographic hash function is to make it hard for Alice to be able to do that. Otherwise, she could find two inputs and cheat in the coin tossing game. This first property of mapping a large input domain to a small fixed output we'll call compression. What we need for a cryptographic hash function is three additional properties. The properties are preimage resistance, which means given the output of the hash function, it's hard to find the input that produced it. This is a form of one-wayness. The other two properties we need concern the collision resistance. The weakest form of this is known as weak collision resistance. What weak collision resistance means is that if we're given some hash value, it's hard to find any input that hashes to the same result. These are sort of similar, right? This one says it's hard to find the actual value of x that was used. This one says it's hard to find any x prime value that hashes to that value. If we have weak collision resistance, that would imply we have a form of preimage resistance as well. And the final property is strong collision resistance, which is exactly the one we saw that we needed for the coin tossing game. And strong collision resistance requires that it's hard to find any pair, x and y, such that the hash of x is equal to the hash of y. So have we seen anything that can do this? And the question is, which of these is almost a good cryptographic hash function? And I'm using almost here in somewhat of a fuzzy way. But I want you to select the one that seems closest to being a good cryptographic hash function. None of them is a perfect cryptographic hash function, and we'll discuss that more after the quiz. So here are the choices. Use cipher block chaining mode to encrypt X, and then take the last output block as the value of the hash. The second choice is to use counter mode to encrypt X, and then take the last output block. The third choice is to use electronic codebook mode to encrypt X, and then take all the output blocks, XOR them all together, and use the result as the hash value. And the fourth choice is to use counter mode to encrypt X, XOR together all the output blocks, and that's the hash value. Which one of these makes the most sense to provide the cryptographic hash function properties that we need?